Hi, my name is Marina, and today we are diving deep into the fascinating world of leaf area measurement. We will explore three different methods of leaf area measurement, but before we dive into the techniques, let's answer the fundamental question. Why do we measure leaf area? Why do we need it? So, as you know, leaves play a crucial role in plants. They're responsible for photosynthesis, where light energy transforms into chemical energy, powering plants' growth. The size of leaf can give insights into various factors affecting plant health, plant growth rate, and overall vitality of the plant. By measuring leaf area, researchers, farmers, and botanists can get some extra information about plants. So, by measuring leaf area, it's not just about the numbers. It's a gateway to understanding the intricate balance of nature and the health of environment. And today I'm excited to show you how you can do it too. You can measure leaf area using different methods. So today we will measure leaf area using grid paper. Also, we will use the software called ImageJ, and finally, we will use a mobile application, Petiole Pro.
First of all, we need to make the contour of our leaf. So we take the grid paper and use either pen or pencil. And then we need to understand the scale of our measurements. So four squares have 4 square centimeters and they are visually separated from each other. So it will be easier to count firstly these big squares. In total, we will have the sum of these squares and count smaller one and the little one, and it will bring us to the overall result. It's our ImageJ, and what do we need to do is to open our photo of the leaf which we made a second ago. A leaf and the ruler. It's very important to have a ruler as well. Nice. So here is our leaf, but also the next step is setting the measurement scale. So let's have these 2 centimeters. No, it's not that perfectly fine. Okay, so let's open our image, our photo of leaf and a ruler next to it. It's very important to have a ruler. Yes, it's here. So firstly, why it's important to have a ruler? Because thanks to this, we can set the scale. And now we are setting it. So it's from 11 till 13. Yes, perfect. And we need to do set the scale. And known distance is 2. And the unit is centimeters. Good. Then we need to zoom out and change the type of image. And then we need to apply the threshold, adjust the threshold. At the same time, we see some minor areas which are not captured perfectly by the segmentation algorithm. So maybe we need to adjust them a little bit more. Good. And then we need to go to the Analyze Tools and find Raw Eye Manager. Here we need to tick the boxes Show All and Labels, and then we need to, on the panel, we need to find the magic wand, and let's make magic. Yes, that's it. You see, if you look closer, it's not perfectly fine because we still see some red dots, but anyway, let's add this measurement and let's measure. So as of now, we see the area is 55 and dot 8. At the same time, if we'll go back a little bit, let's go down with this, maybe here. And if we will look closer to the leaf, we can see that some areas are slightly incorrectly captured. So that's why we need to consider this. At the same time, for overall general purposes, it's okay, it's fine, and we have the good segmentation of the main leaf, not just some problems with petiole here, but the leaf is fine.
Leaf fairy with Petiole Pro, first of all, you need to capture the photo of your leaf placed on calibrating plate. Please don't cover any markers visible on the calibrating plate since it impacts the accuracy. Then you need to upload this photo into your mobile application and you will see the magic, the area of your leaf. And you also have this chance to select the best segmentation, which is more accurate. In our case, it provides the result of 55.1 square centimeters. Also, you are able to save the measurement and go back to them when you will need them and share them with your colleagues and collaborators and just enjoy the history of your research. I hope you enjoyed this video and now you see the clear understanding which tool will be helpful to you in your research and growing practice. Please ask any questions if you will have any below or using the email. And yes, thank you. See you next time.